Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, Kevin.
You're all very welcome here to St. Patrick's for the first wedding since the coronavirus hit our shores. Gary and Lisa were supposed to be married in April, if my memory serves me right. And Gary has been beaten down my door. Almost on a daily basis with emails and so forth to ensure that this day could take place. Along with welcoming you here to St. Patrick's, I welcome also to all Alicia's family in Poland who will be tuning in to the wedding mass later on today. We're not just that advanced with Facebook, but it is being taped at the moment. Well, on YouTube later on this evening in Polska. At any rate, brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate this wedding mass, we pause for a wee moment to bring ourselves into the presence of God and to call to mind those times in our lives when we have failed to show love.
To Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you are Lord of the Holy One, you are Lord of the Lord, you are Lord of the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love these your servants, Alicia and Gary, who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that, as you make their love fruitful, they may become, by your grace, witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And thank you now, Father, to be seated while Justina will read the scripture passages for us.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
invite you to stand for the gospel. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. No one can have greater love than to lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Just have to be seated for a moment now. Gary, I thought this might interest you. Some months ago, I saw an advertisement in the local newspaper which read, "For sale by owner, complete set of Encyclopedia Britannica, 45 volumes, excellent condition, no longer needed. Got married last month, wife knows everything." At any rate, a professor of philosophy once stood in front of his lecture theatre with several items on the desk in front of him. And when the lecture began, he picked up a very large sweetie jar and proceeded to fill it with golf balls. He then asked the students if the jar was full, and they agreed that it was. The professor then picked up a box of pebbles and shook them into the sweetie jar. He shook the jar lightly, and the pebbles rolled into the open areas between golf balls. He then asked the students again if the jar was full, and again they all agreed that it was. The professor next picked up a box of sand and poured that into the sweetie jar. And of course, the sand filled up everything else. Once more, he asked if the jar was full, and the students replied with a unanimous yes. The professor then picked up two cups of coffee from under his desk and poured the liquid into the sweetie jar, effectively filling the empty space between the grains of sand. "Now," said the professor, "I want you to recognize that this jar represents your life. The golf balls are the important things. God, your faith, your hopes, your love, your family, your spouse, your children, your health, your peace of mind, the peace in your home, your friends, your favorite passions. In short, things that if everything else was lost and only they remained, your life would still be full. The pebbles are the other things that matter, like your job, your house, your apartment, your car, your savings, and so forth. The sand is everything else, the small stuff. If you put the sand into the jar first," he continued, "there is no room for the pebbles or the golf balls. The same goes for life. If you spend all your time and energy on the small stuff, you'll never have room for the things that are really important to you. So," said the professor, "pay attention to the things that are critical to your life and to your well-being. Say your prayers, go to Mass, go on pilgrimage to Loch Derr or Kilpatrick or Yasnamora. Go on pilgrimage to Lourdes. Take your spouse out to dinner or to some other treat. Take the time and make the checkups. Play another match. There will always be time to clean the house or wash the car. Take care of the golf balls first, the things that really matter. Set your priorities, because the rest is only sand." One of the students raised her hand and asked what the coffee represented. And the professor smiled and replied, "Well, it just goes to show that no matter how full your life may seem, there's always room for a couple of cups of coffee with a friend." So, Alicia and Gary, as you begin married life together, set your priorities for your married life. And remember, the rest is only sand. And since I know no one is interested in looking at the priest during a wedding ceremony, we'll now swap places so that I'm at the risk of upsetting Gary. No one really wants to see you either, Gary. My experience wedding is they only want to see the bride. So we'll swap places for the rite of marriage.
Dear children of God, you have come to this church so that the Lord may see your love in the presence of the priest and this community. Christ blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism. Now, by a special sacrament, he strengthens you to fulfill the duties of your married life. Alicia and Gary, you are about to celebrate this sacrament. Have you come here of your own free will and choice, and without compulsion, to marry each other?
Yeah.
Will you love and honor each other in marriage all the days of your life?
Yeah.
Are you willing to accept with love the children God may send you, and bring them up in accordance with the law of Christ and His Church?
Yeah.
I invite you then to declare before God and His Church your consent become husband and wife. Gary, do you take Alicia as your wife, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, all the days of your life?
I do.
Alicia, do you take Gary as your husband, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, all the days of your life? What God joins together, man must not separate. May the Lord confirm the consent that you have given and enrich you with His blessings. Lord, bless Gary and Alicia and consecrate their married life. May these rings be a symbol of their love and faith in each other through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Alicia, wear this ring as a sign of our faithful love. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I give you this gold and silver, tokens of all I possess.
I think we can give him a round of applause.
Thank you.
Thank you, Gary and Alicia. That's just a prayer of the newly married couple. I'm ready now to stand for the prayers of the faithful. Now that Alicia and Gary have given themselves to each other in Christian marriage, let us ask God our Father to keep them and all married couples faithful to Him and united in themselves. We ask you, Lord, to bless Alicia and Gary, to protect them, and to grant them a long and happy life together. May they always remain in your love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all married people here today, may they be reminded of the joy of their own wedding day. And may Alicia and Gary give thanks for the happiness they have known, and may each day find them ever more devoted to each other. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We thank you, Lord, this afternoon for the gift of friendship and love. We pray for our families and friends gathered here to celebrate this special day, either physically or virtually. May we continue to rejoice with each other in good times and lean on each other in times of need. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We bring to mind members of our families and friends from around the globe who are unable to be here today. We think especially of Alicia's parents and family members in Poland. We know they are with us in spirit, sharing in this celebration. May the peace of Christ reside in them today and every day. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
I give thanks today, as I did at Kenneth Mass here this morning, I've mentioned to Gary and Alicia, I give thanks today. We share the 8th of July, because the 8th of July is the day I was ordained a priest 30 years ago. So I give thanks to this wedding Mass for those 30 years of ministry in the Archdiocese of Armagh, and pray God's continued blessing on me. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those we have loved, who have departed this life. We remember in particular deceased members of our respective families. May God one day unite us in the joy of our eternal home. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray. God our Father, you have taught us that love is the fulfilling of the law. May Gary and Alicia continue to grow in love for each other and always remain in your love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And I'd like you now to be seated for the offertory. Lord, the offerings we bring in gladness before you and in your fatherly love,
What true are those you have joined in the sacrament and covenant through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have forged the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of the children brings beauty to the world, their rebirth and baptism gives increase to the Church through Christ the Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end, we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy the holy gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. My Lord and my God. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, our Bishop, Michael, his assistant bishop, Sean, our retired bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Be mindful also, Lord, of Alicia and Gary, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love and in peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your peace. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Patrick, St. Bridget, St. Malachy, St. Columba, St. Casimirus, St. Stanislaw, St. Wojciech, St. Faustina Kowalska, St. Maximilian Kolbe, Pope St. John Paul II, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through him, and with him, and in him. O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you all now to stand as we pray together the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
At this point in the wedding mass, I invite Gary and Alicia to kneel for a special blessing on your wedding day. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that on these, his servants, Gary and Alicia, now married in Christ, he may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace and make of one heart in love, by the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, those he has joined by a holy covenant. We pray in silence for a wee moment for Alicia and Gary and for their future married life. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might no longer be two but one flesh, and talk what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with the one blessing not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Look now with favour on these your servants, Alicia and Gary, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour out your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter Alicia, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband Gary entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honour and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to faith and keep your commandments. Made one in the flesh, may they be blameless in all they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with the children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children, and grant the preaching and class together the fullness of years for which they hope. They may come to the light of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And since we are unable to exchange the sign of peace with each other, let me just take a wee moment to pray for peace in our hearts and in our world. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal and blessed sin. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be.
I am going to give Alicia and Gary Holy Communion first, after which they're going to occupy these two seats while Daniel will move the kneeler. And for the distribution of Holy Communion, I distribute to this side first. You come out this side with me and I and return to your seat that way. And then I distribute to this side next. And again, we come out this seat to me and I and return that way. Anyone who is not of the Catholic faith and wishes to receive a blessing, please feel free to come forward. Just cross your arms and cross your chest. I want to give you a blessing.
Thank you.
sacrament, most holy sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanks to you in every moment now.
O sacrament, most holy sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanks to you in every moment now.
O sacrament, most holy sacrament divine,
all praise and all thanks to you in every moment now. O sacred heart of Jesus,
I place all my trust in you.
Immaculate heart of Mary,
pray for us.
For protection today and every day. O angel of
God,
my guardian
angel,
to whom God's love commits thee here, ever this day be on my side,
to light
the guard,
to whom God.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us stand and pray. Having been made partakers of your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united in the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just before the final blessing, congratulate Alicia and Gary on your getting married. You did brilliantly, no hiccups at all, as far as I can see. Mind you, I wasn't wearing my glasses. These vows that you swear you're going to do a frontal lobotomy when you're going to distribute Holy Communion. But we have to observe all these things, and we particularly anxious that the people in Poland would see that we would be very correct with the daughter of Poland, the daughters of Poland who are here, and we're looking after them. Thank you to all who came today. Thank you to Gary and Lisa for inviting me to officiate. A special word of thanks to Father Brendan, who's here as well, Gary, who received you into the Catholic Church within last year. And thank you also to Cranmer for adding so much dignity and reverence to Catherine's wedding mass. So the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God, the Eternal Father, keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home.
Amen.
May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone.
Amen.
May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God.
Amen.
Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God. Amen.